Assalamualaikum and hello to Dr. Jeriza and our fellow friends. We are group from Group Valorant. The next. This is our group member. We have Syami Ashraf, Darwish Hakim, Solihin and also me, Arif Farhan. So our group will present about vegetable transplanter. So in the subtopic of the report, we have introduction, type and function, component, maintenance and care, sustainability and restriction, and conclusion. For introduction, we need to know what is shelter agriculture. Shelter agriculture is a plant or crops are grown in structure with mostly transparent walls or transparent roof. So what is vegetable transplanter? Vegetable transplanter is a mechanism which provide to pick up the seedling from the transplant production tray. There is two type of vegetable transplanter, which is riding and walking type.
Okay, thank you Arif Farhan for good introduction. And now let we talk about type vegetable transplanter and function. Okay, the type of vegetable transplanter have two type. The first one is riding type and the second one is walking type. The riding type is power driven and can transplant two lines in one pass, and the second one is walking type, manual drive and can transplant one line in one pass. Okay, let we talk about the function of vegetable transplanter. The first is for specialized transplanter. It used to transplant seedling into field, and also the vegetable transplanter is mainly used for transplanting seedling cultivated by nursery seeding machine, and can also transplant cotton, tomato, pepper, lettuce and other crops. It includes two types, such as tractor driven transplanting machine and self propelled transplanting machine. This is for type and the function, and also the riding vegetable transplanter also got many model to use for crop. That's it. Next, so we can okay. Next is about component that have at the vegetable transplanter. Okay, the first one we can see the main speed shift level. This one is for to change speed by level, like level one, what speed we need. The second one is planting distance adjusting handle. This used for adjust distance between seedling. Let's say we want to the seedling 2 inch one by one, so we can adjust it. The third one is accelerator level. Power level or the pilot controls the amount of fuel provided to the engine which is associated. Okay, this one for how much fuel we need to use lah. Okay, next is planting depth adjusting level. To adjust how depth of the planted crop. Let's say we want to the depth is 2 inches, 3 inches. We can adjust it lah. Okay, the next is up down level to adjust the level of the seedling holding. Next, handle head adjusting level. To adjust the head of handle, we force step according to the head of reach or operator. Because everyone has what we call not same head. Next is main clutch lever allows the main casting to lift off the driven disc. The last one is choke lever to restrict the flow of air, trapping and reaching the full air mixture while starting the engine. This one used for start the engine of vegetable transplanter lah. Okay next we talk about how this we talk about component that make it happen lah, make the vegetable transplanter happen. Okay, the first one is claw cover to protect seedling. The second one is needle claw. Take out the seedling carefully. This one di take out and then put at the ridge. The third one, soil covering roller. Cover soil over the seedling and avoid the soil entering to the shaft. And the last one is soil covering pressure adjustment lever. Change the wagging of covering soil and covers the seedling. This one to make shape the soil lah. Make it look like rich. That's all for me. From me. Okay. Thank you.
I will explain about maintenance and care for the vegetable transplanter. Okay, firstly, they clean the transplanter after the vegetable transplanting. Okay, for the one day, you use the vegetable transplanter. You always clean the transplanter. Okay, and the next is check the condition of the needle flow. It's the pickup needle. Flow damage seriously and replace them. Okay, for the next is replace the engine oil and gear oil regularly according to the requirement on the operation instruction. Okay, and the next is the check whether the component are in a good condition and adjust them. And lastly, they always wash the machine by water and remove the dust from a rotating part after the drying the machine. Lubricant is a rotating and moving part. Okay, for the important note, that's it. Do not spray water on the electrical device, and otherwise the electrical device may be damaged. And after washing the machine, be sure to lubricant all the lubricant point. Otherwise, when you see the machine next time, it may not operate smoothly and properly. Okay, next page. For the maintenance and care, we continue. Okay, for the firstly, is before the vegetable transplanter enter the field, check whether the support wheel is the transplanting stake raised the two front leg and fit it with the bottom hole. And the next is the when the transplanter enter the field, the tractor must move slowly while lowering the transplanter machine. And the next is the when the transplanter machine turn around and stop placing the seedling, read the operation instruction carefully. The next is the check the machine carefully before using the vegetable transplanter. And make sure the component is in a good condition. If there is something wrong with the machine, adjust it or replace it. Okay. And lastly, the oil the machine properly and check whether the seedling box is properly installed. Okay. Thank you.
Now I will talk to you about the suitability of machinery in shelter agriculture. So as we know, shelter agriculture is the machine size must be appropriate for the farm use. We know that sometimes we build a shelter agriculture a bigger size or a small size, so we need to considering the type of machine size to use on the farm. Next one is the total power needed to operate the machine. In addition, we talk about the machine size, so we need to know what is the total power that we need to specify before we use it on the farm. And the next helps with the farmer needs. What about the restriction in shelter agriculture? The first point is only a specific machinery is suitable. So this point is means that not all of the agriculture machinery can be used in the sheltered agriculture because sheltered agriculture is not like the normal agriculture farm, like using a big machinery, massive machinery. So in sheltered agriculture, we only use a specific machinery, like a small machinery that can use a lot in the farm. Next one is considering the farm size, which will influence the number, diversity of machine and suitable certification of machine power needed. As I said, we need a specific machine that have a low machine power or high machine power to be needed in the certain farm of agriculture shelter. Next one. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is to maintaining and caring for the machine is the most important thing when it comes to agriculture, to ensure that the machine lasts longer and is not easily damaged. Second, proper use of vegetable transplanter not only prolongs the life of the machine but maintains the safety of the user. Next one, the machine we intend to employ on our farm must be able to withstand our farm condition. It all depends on the size of our farm, the amount of capital we have, and the needs we have on the farm. So this is several of our reference about the our presentation today. So we can see we use a lot of YouTube to make up our presentation content. And I think that's all from our group. And thank you for your listening. And if you have any question, you can ask we on the chat box or open the mic. All right, that's all from us, and thank you.